Hello and welcome back to this channel. Dear students, this topic is architecture of PIC18FXXXX microcontroller. It is the topic from the subject microcontrollers. Earlier in this subject we have studied 8051 microcontroller. Now we will be discussing about PIC. So presently we are talking about the architecture diagram. From the exam point of view, we may expect a straightforward question: draw the architecture or simplified version or simplified block diagram of PIC microcontroller and explain its functioning. अब देखो, इस पूरे यूनिट में हर एक ब्लॉक हम लोगों को डिटेल में लर्न करना है. प्रेजेंटली इफ यू वॉन्ट टू राइट एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ दिस ब्लॉक डायग्राम, I have given some points. I have written few points. You need to mention these points in your answer. So to start with, first block, this block I am talking about is flash program memory. It basically stores the program that you are going to execute. So that is the main function of the flash memory. Then this block is a stack. We have already studied. जैसे 8051 में भी हम लोगों ने learn किया है. Stack मतलब एक reserved memory है. So some reserved memory is there which is required to store the data temporarily. That's the function of stack. Then program counter मतलब PC. Basically ये जो program counter है, that is 21-bit register. We have learned register का मतलब है to store the data temporarily. So it is 21-bit register which holds address of instruction in the memory. It tracks the program execution. मतलब जिस address से हमें data access करना है, उसका address, that address will be stored in the PC, which is basically 21-bit register, and then we can fetch that information, that data, and passes, we can pass it through the ALU, depending on the program that you want to execute. Next is IR, that is this block, instruction register. This block, instruction register, is basically used to fetch the data from flash memory. मतलब flash memory से ये data fetch करता है and stores it in instruction register and then it passes to the instruction decoder. मतलब सिर्फ इसका instruction register का function इतना ही है कि flash memory से data fetch करना. You may well show the connection over here. तो ये डेटा फेच करेगा फ्लैश मेमोरी से एंड देन इट विल बी स्टोर्ड टेम्पररीली फॉर टाइम बीइंग एंड देन इट विल बी ट्रांसफर्ड टू द इंस्ट्रक्शन डिकोडर. अब आईडी मतलब इंस्ट्रक्शन डिकोडर, जैसे एज द नेम इंडिकेट्स, इट डिकोड्स द इंस्ट्रक्शन एंड जनरेट्स कंट्रोल सिग्नल. मतलब जो भी इंस्ट्रक्शन है, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शन इन डिटेल इन द सेम यूनिट. प्रेजेंटली जो भी इंस्ट्रक्शन है वो डिकोड करना पड़ेगा एंड अकॉर्डिंगली एक कंट्रोल सिग्नल जनरेट करना पड़ेगा. सो दैट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शन डिकोडर, दैट इज आईडी. आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस ब्लॉक. देन FSR, दैट इज फाइल सिलेक्ट रजिस्टर. दिस ब्लॉक बेसिकली FSR, फाइल सिलेक्ट रजिस्टर. As the name indicates, जैसे देखो 8051 में भी हम लोग अलग अलग banks use करते थे, register का banks use करते थे. The meaning of word bank means number of registers are combined together. तो वो select करने के लिए, एक particular register bank select करने के लिए या file select करने के लिए, register file select करने के लिए FSR use करते. So it is file select register which selects a particular register or file. Then I have shown at two places. This is also MUX, that is multiplexer. This is also MUX. We know that in digital electronics we have learned it is 4:1 MUX, 2:1 MUX, 8:1 MUX. Likewise, this is multiplexer. The major function of multiplexer is selects the data from internal buses and give it to the ALU. ये जो multiplexer है, internal bus से data select करेंगे, मतलब ये data select करेंगे और instruction register का भी जो signal है वो multiplex करेंगे and then data, that particular data is passed through ALU. We know that ALU is arithmetic and logic unit. अब देखो, जैसे मैंने बताया ALU is arithmetic logic unit, मतलब arithmetic operations perform करने के लिए use कर सकते हैं ये PIC controller, that is for addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, as well as it is performing logical operations like AND, OR and so on. So that is the major function of ALU, arithmetic and logic unit. अब देखो, अगर instructions में दो operands है, तो दो registers use करते हैं. One is W रजिस्टर मतलब वर्किंग रजिस्टर, एंड सेकंड इज द फाइल रजिस्टर। जैसे मैंने बताया ये सिर्फ जनरलाइज डिस्कशन है, मतलब आर्किटेक्चर का क्वेश्चन अगर आता है तो यू नीड टू राइट फ्यू पॉइंट्स, आई मीन वन और टू सेंटेंसेस फॉर ईच ब्लॉक, इसके लिए दिया है। अदरवाइज पूरे यूनिट में हम लोग ये एक एक ब्लॉक डिटेल में डिस्कस करने वाले हैं। ऑलराइट, तो अगर दो ऑपरेंड्स हैं तो एक वन ऑपरेंड विल बी स्टोर्ड इन डब्ल्यू रजिस्टर, दैट इज दिस वर्किंग रजिस्टर, एंड सेकंड विल बी इन फाइल रजिस्टर। ये हम लोग बाद में डिटेल में लर्न करने वाले हैं। देन अबाउट दिस डब्ल्यू रजिस्टर, एज द नेम इंडिकेट्स इट इज वर्किंग रजिस्टर। बेसिकली डब्ल्यू रजिस्टर इज यूज टू सपोर्ट द ऑपरेशंस ऑफ एएलयू। सो व्हाट आई हैव रिटन, इट इज 8 बिट वाइड and it is used to source for one or two operand instructions to be processed in ALU. मतलब W register में operand store करके that will be supplied to the ALU for further processing. But it is not addressable register and its length is 8 bit. Then status register, इस diagram में नहीं दिखा है, as the name indicates, इसलिए इसके आगे सिर्फ मैंने फ्लैग्स लिखा है। एज द नेम इंडिकेट्स इट प्रोवाइड्स अ पर्टिकुलर स्टेटस। फॉर एग्जांपल अलग अलग फ्लैग्स है, जैसे 8051 में हम लोगों ने लर्न किया सिमिलर फ्लैग्स आर देयर लाइक कैरी फ्लैग, देन ओवरफ्लो फ्लैग एंड सो ऑन। सो दैट इज दैट इंडिकेशन इज रिलेटेड टू स्टेटस रजिस्टर। देन इट ऑल्सो हैज रैम फाइल रजिस्टर। सो नंबर ऑफ रजिस्टर्स आर अवेलेबल इन रैम फाइल and address of that particular thing is stored in the RAM file. So that is the function of RAM file register. जैसे ये एक block यहाँ पे देखा है, this is input-output port. As the name indicates, जैसे 8051 में हम लोगों ने learn किया था LED interfacing कर सकते हैं, फिर stepper motor connect कर सकते हैं, and so on. There are n number of applications. Likewise, there are similar applications as far as this PIC microcontroller is concerned. So that connection is given to input and output port. It is a bi-directional because it is you can well connect a device which is will act as an input, as well as you can well give some instructions to the device which is connected externally, so it will act as an output port. यहाँ पे this is basically this contains 33 lines and it has 5 ports. These ports are A, B, C, D and E. अब ब्रैकेट में मैंने हर एक पोर्ट का, मतलब जैसे मैंने बताया 5 पोर्ट्स आर देयर ए बी सी डी एंड ई, हर एक पोर्ट का, पोर्ट ए है तो इट विल बी हैविंग 6 बिट्स, देन बी सी डी 8 बिट्स एंड ई विल बी हैविंग 3 बिट्स। अब इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट है यहां पे जो मैंने दिखाया है इंटरनल कंट्रोल सर्किट, उसके अंदर ये अलग अलग ब्लॉक्स है। फर्स्ट इज वॉचडॉग टाइमर, ये जैसे एज द नेम इंडिकेट्स it is basically providing some external timing circuitry as well as provide certain control signals. So first block is watchdog timer. ये सब हम लोग बाद में detail learn करने वाले हैं. First is watchdog timer. If any malfunctioning is there, then it is used to restart the microcontroller. Then brownout reset, BROWNOUT, brownout reset, it is used for to give the protection to the microcontroller whenever there is a voltage fluctuation. जैसे देखो अगर low voltage आता है तो it should not hamper the microcontroller, तो वो protection provide करने के लिए this brownout reset is used. Then oscillator start, ये सब as the name indicates, it itself gives the functioning, oscillator startup timer, then low voltage programmer and debugger. तो ये 5 blocks, these are contained in this internal control circuit. मतलब block diagram draw करते वक्त आप यहाँ पे instead of writing here internal control circuit, आप ये 5 block यहाँ इसके अंदर बना सकते हो. So these are the this is the case for input output ports and internal control circuit. Remaining blocks are very simple, straightforward oscillator. जैसे हम लोगों को पता है, we need to apply certain clock signals which will generate the machine cycles and so on. That is the function of this oscillator. Then timers and counters to produce the delay operations. In many applications, it is required to provide a certain amount of delay. So that is the major function of timers and counters. Peripherals, as the name indicates, different peripherals can be well connected. And this EEPROM, which provides certain, you can use the memory repeatedly with the help of EEPROM. So this is the generalized explanation of the architecture, I mean general architecture of PIC 18F XXXX. Next, features of this PIC microcontroller. We may expect a direct question like list out some important features of PIC18FXXXX. I have made a list of some important features. So first is, it makes use of low power and high speed flash technology, which is embedded flash technology. Then its CPU, central processing unit, is 8-bit with reduced instruction set. We have studied in earlier unit what is RISC architecture. So it makes up use of reduced instruction set architecture. Then instructions are 16-bit long. It makes use of memory which contains 2 megabytes of ROM, then 4 KB data RAM, 32 KB flash ROM, 1536 byte scratchpad area or SRAM, and 256 bytes EEPROM, which is used to store some critical information. Then it makes use of 5 input and output ports. While studying the block diagram, hum logon ne discuss kiya ki port A, port B, port C, port D, and port E. There are 5 input output ports. We have already discussed the length of each and every input output port. So it is basically operated by using 32 bidirectional lines. Then there are different register banks which we are going to study in detail. Hum logon ne 8051 mein bhi learn kiya hai. Ek register bank mein bahut sare registers hote. So it has 15 bank registers with 256 entries. Then it contains ADC, analog to digital converter, which is on chip ADC having 10 bits and 8 channels. Then important feature is CCP module, that is capture, compare and PWM module. Again, we are going to study it in detail. Then it has provision of addressable USART, that is universal synchronous asynchronous receiver transmitter module for serial communication. Then we already discussed it consists of brownout reset. Whenever there is any malfunctioning, then it is used to reset the microcontroller, as well as it has the provision to give indication for low voltage detection. Whenever there is a detection of low voltage, it provides interrupt signal, and accordingly the resetting of microcontroller takes place. Then its operating voltage is having a wide range from 2.2 volt to 5.5 volt, as well as it supports the power saving sleep mode. The next parameters are, it has high current sink and source, that is 25 milliampere and 25 milliampere. Then it has in-circuit debugger. This also we have discussed in block diagram. Then it supports 4 timers, timer 0, timer 1, timer 2 and timer 3. And it supports 3 external interrupts, that is INTR 0, 1 and 2. Now let us discuss the functioning of ALU. जैसे मैंने बताया while studying the concept of architecture, हर एक block इस unit में हम लोगों को detail में learn करना है. So first is functioning of ALU. From the example point of view, we may expect the direct question like explain the functioning of arithmetic and logic unit. So this diagram shows you the functioning of ALU, that is arithmetic and logic unit. We have discussed that CPU, that is central processing unit, fetches the instructions from the memory. Then instruction decoder block is there in the block diagram or in the architecture that decodes the instruction, and then it is passed to the ALU, that is arithmetic and logic unit. As the name indicates, ALU is responsible for arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and logical operations like AND, OR, and so on. So that is the major function of arithmetic and logic unit. Now, जैसे इस डायग्राम में दिखाया है, it contains one multiplexer. One input to this multiplexer is from program data memory, and second is from the register file. उससे पहले दो important registers याद रखने, one is W register, that is working register, which is connected to the ALU, and another is file register. उसके अलावा status register भी है, जो ALU का operation है, उसका status क्या होगा, मतलब overflow है, तो carry है, accordingly the flags will be generated. Alright, presently we are talking about only two register. तो ये जो मल्टीप्लेक्सर है उसका एक इनपुट दिया है फ्रॉम द प्रोग्राम डेटा मेमोरी, अनदर इनपुट इज फ्रॉम द रजिस्टर फाइल व्हिच इज बेसिकली स्पेशल फंक्शन रजिस्टर एंड जीपीआर, दिस इज रिलेटेड टू प्रोग्राम मेमोरी. सो दीज आर द टू इनपुट्स, मल्टीप्लेक्सर मल्टीप्लेक्सेस दीज टू इनपुट्स एंड इट इज अप्लाइड टू द एएलयू. Another input to the ALU is from W register, that is working register. Then ALU performs the operation and generates one bit which is called a D bit. देखो ये जो data है, this is 8 bit data. The data from program data memory is also 8 bit data. Let us consider one example. Suppose the instruction is add WF. What this instruction means? It indicates that add the contents of W register and F register, that is working register and file register. दोनों के contents add करेंगे. Addition, this addition will be done by ALU. Addition का जो result आएगा वो हमें store करना है. Either it is stored in W register or somewhere else, that is F register. तो ये जो addition करने के बाद एक bit generate होगा, that is called D bit. If value of DBT is 0, then data is stored, result is stored in W register. जैसे देखो यहाँ D is equal to 0 लिखा है, मतलब अगर answer DBT का value अगर 0 है तो that data is stored in W register. If value of DBT is 1, it is stored in F register, that is this register 5. So this is the simple example. Likewise, अगर हम लोग product ले रहे हैं दो operands का, so result will be, let us say 16 bits. Then again accumulator is capable of storing this 16 bit value. The next part is PSW, that is program status word, or it is also called status register, or it is also called flag register. Again, we can expect the direct question related to this. Draw the diagram for PSW and explain the functioning of each bit or status register or flag register. So it is basically 8-bit register, bit number 0, 1, 2 up to bit number 7. These three bits, bit number 5, 6, 7 are unused. You may write here 0, 0, 0. Next, bit number 4 is negative bit, N bit. As the name indicates, it will be set to 1 if the result of operation, that means if the result of ALU, arithmetic and logic operation, is negative, then it is set to 1, and it means MSB bit of result is 1, that is most significant bit of result is 1. ये basically PSW जो register है, that is ये use करते हैं ALU के contents indicate करने के लिए. So it is also acting as a flag register. तो जैसे मैंने बताया, result अगर negative है तो this bit will be set to 1. If result is positive, this bit is set to 1. Positive result है, इसका मतलब है MSB bit of result is equals to 0. Next is overflow flag, that is bit number 3. Again, same logic, similar logic. This is set to 1 if there is a overflow flow from signed arithmetic. मतलब दो arithmetic को operation कर रहे, signed arithmetic है, and if overflow occurs, then it is set to 1, otherwise it is set to 0. Then bit number 2 is Z bit, that is 0 bit. If result of arithmetic operation is 0, then it is set to 1, and if result is 1, it is set to 0. Then next is DC bit, that is direct or half carry bit. If the carry generated from 3rd to 4th bit of operation, from 3rd to 4th bit, then only this flag is set to 1, otherwise it is set to 0. Then last bit, that is bit number 0, is C bit, that is carry bit. So it is set to 1 if there is a carry from the MSB of the result. So this is about the status register or flag register or program status word. So dear students, that's it for today's session. So thank you. Thanks a lot for watching this video.